I also have a degenerative neuropathy. My legs don't work. My hands look kind of sci-fi. I have had 9 surgeries to make life in this body more comfortable. I've also had Botox. But these things, these challenges, are not what define me or my life. My name is Chaeli, I'm 19 years old. I am a first year student at the University of Cape Town. I have incredible friends. I write, I speak, I dance, I cycle. I'm proud to climb mountains. These are the things that I choose to define my life by. I'm lucky to have been born to the family that I have. They have taught me that my disability is not who I am. They have taught me that I have control over how I choose to live my life. I've learned that the only way you can truly reach your potential is by admitting that there are some things that you cannot achieve on your own. We need help sometimes. I have so many people in my life who see the possibility and the positivity of my life. Regardless of my disability, I've never been treated differently by the people who are close to me. They see me before my disability. They have expectations of me. They call me out when I don't reach my expectations. That's the way it is. That's the way it's supposed to be. But the thing is, we don't just interact with the people who are close to us. The people who understand our issues and accept them. We interact with people who have different beliefs, different perspectives, different life stories. People who differ from us in every way. They don't always understand our issues and accept them. Or even acknowledge them. So this is problematic if we're planning on living in a world without challenge. I'm generally seen as a pretty positive person. This is not always the case. I definitely have my negativity days where I don't see positivity in anything. On these days, I generally don't leave home. And there are very few people in my life who have seen this side of me. I think it's important that people know that I'm not a superhuman and I have emotions just as anybody else does. But here again, it's about choice. I can choose to wallow in the negativity of things not working out the way I wanted them to. Or I can choose to look at a situation and work towards making it better. I also need help sometimes to get into this mindset. But let's talk about my life a little bit. Past challenges, successes, hopes, and future. I've never been able to walk independently. I got my first wheelchair when I was 3 years old. But there were no wheelchairs made for my size. So I was so tiny that the 16-inch wheelchair was more like a swimming pool. And we had to come up with creative ways of dealing with this. But we found the magic that happened when you strategically place polystyrene and foam. This is what we got. When I was younger, I pretty much did the same things as anybody else my age. All the lines and passes that you're meant to do, I did. Melodies and going guys, even ballet. Ballet was interesting. my parents thought it was important for me to experience everything possible. So they found ways to make that happen. And there were other girls who had the same disability as I have. And we got to do better. Admittedly, it's not regular better. But we also got to put on the tutu. And I can now tell my children the stories about when I did better, just as any other girl does. I've also sampled it. It was on a body camp and everyone was doing it. We devised a plan for me to also participate in the activity. It took three attempts to find a method that was effective. I dislocated a finger in this experience. And people are often horrified when they find out that I get injured when I'm doing these things. And I don't really understand why, because other children get injured and hurt themselves when they play, and it shouldn't be any different for me. My injuries just take a little bit more planning. It's important to be able to tell these stories. It's important that I can do things that other people do. All my life, it has been a priority for my family to have me be included in as much as possible. So this attitude led to some creative ways of changing games so that I could join. Some games we had to change, but others were perfect the way they were. I dominated that mud. As I got older, I got involved in other activities, horse riding, which I did for 6 years, and then I found dancing. I did a ballroom and Latin American dancing with my able-bodied partner Damien. And dancing has become my passion. The thing I love about being a wheelchair dancer is that we get to prove that ability is found through self-belief. All these things that I've done have only been possible because we were and are willing to do things differently and to work together to make things happen. But in our lives, we often become complacent with the way things are, and we don't question. And then something happens that changes the way that you look at your life, and it does force you to question why things are the way they are. I had this moment last September. I was approached by a grad student to do the Cape Audio Speaking Day Cycle Tour. Every year we would stand at Ladies' Mile and scream encouragement at the cyclists as they go under the bridge. I never imagined that I would be going under the bridge instead of screaming from the top. So I was skeptical. I have never seen myself as a cyclist. Well, obviously. And then Brian convinced me that cycling the 109 kilometers was a good idea. So we immediately went into planning mode because having decided that we are now doing this, we now had to find a way of doing this. This is what we found. And this is a defining moment in my life. It allowed me to question why things are the way they are. And more than that, it has rather than asking why, I now ask why not. So, on the 10th of March, 2013, we conquered the cyclotour in 5 hours, 29 minutes, and 43 seconds. The 17 seconds make a difference. It was an unbelievable experience. So many things I never thought I would do happened that day. Riding with 35,000 people, going 68.8 kilometers per hour downhill. The 35,000 people I was prepared for, but the 68.8 kilometers, that's much. I've learned many lessons in that buggy that I will take with me for the rest of my life. I learned how to trust someone completely. Having belief in the people around you is so important, not only in the cycling, but in life. Another lesson I've learned through this experience is around control. I generally like to be in control, but it's not really possible when I am attached to the back of God's bicycle. So, what do you do then? You let it go. I think these are amazing things to learn, that in life, sometimes we can't be in control. And we have to just trust that things will work out. Another incredible realization I had, a buggy with me, is that my doing that on the central tour was such an empowering thing in my life. But I depend on God for this empowerment to happen to you. So this brings us back to the idea that we need help to reach our potential. We have to help each other out. We need to find people who join our life story, who will see the possibility where we do not. People who will keep us positive and support us when we need it. I have found these people who do it for me, and I'm so happy to have them in my life. Since I've now been classified as a crazy adventurer, there are now plans happening to climb Kilimanjaro in September 2014. It's quite a logistical nightmare to organize climbing a mountain in a wheelchair. As you can learn. But we're excited and we're positive about it and we're determined to conquer Kilimanjaro. So keep watching, because then you'll see the hysteria that will no doubt be happening as we prepare for this incredible journey. But the message I hope to leave with you out of this talk is don't be afraid of people thinking that you're crazy. Believe in your ability to change the world. And be open to other people changing you.